In this video, I'll be covering the main features of Noteshelf, one of my favorite note-taking apps. I will also share what I love about this app and where I think they could still improve. Without further ado, let's go. Hey guys, this is iOSir. I will do iOS app reviews and share some helpful tips to let you make the best of your iOS devices. So if you're also an iOSir, subscribe to this channel and stay tuned. Noteshelf is one of the most popular note-taking apps in the App Store, which will be a $9.99 lifetime purchase. After that, you can get access to this app on your iPad, iPhone, or even Apple Watch. In Noteshelf, you have this note section in which you can create different notes and categorize them. First of all, let's create a new notebook. As you guys can see, you can choose covers for your notebooks from these categories. If you find these artistic covers too regular for your book, fine, you can actually go to the Noteshelf Club for so much more resources. Sign up for this online club to download plenty of beautiful patterns. Also, you can browse other people's design in the inspirations to get inspired. So we pick a random one and here we go. Then select the page template from all of these, light or dark, plain, ruled, checked, legal, dotted, or likewise download from the club. Next, we'll name the book. Okay, there are four types of pen in Noteshelf, which are ball pen, fountain pen, and this one's sort of like a gel pen, and lastly, pencil. Each of them has different writing experience. I personally use fountain pen the most, because it modifies your writing into good calligraphy. Then you can use other pen styles to draw or etc. Adjust the color by using presets, customizing, or add given palettes. After figuring out your own preferences, you can add particular combinations to favorites and optionally choose to show your favorites below the toolbar. Same here with highlighter, except there's two shapes of tip for highlighter. You can also add your combination to favorites. Next, we move on to the eraser. Three sizes allow you to choose, or you can choose auto size so that the size of eraser depends on how fast you erase. If you want to clear out the entire page, just click clear page and you're all set. And you might notice there are three options below. You can be automatically taken to the last tool you used after erasing. No need to switch manually. Also, you can make your erase more efficiently by toggle on erase entire stroke or highlighter only. Have to say the eraser in Noteshelf is so far my favorite out of many note-taking apps that I used. Okay, now we're picking out the text stain. You can tap anywhere on the page to type, move the text box around to reposition, then choose the size, fonts, make them bold, italic, or underline them. Also, you can add your combination to your favorites. Besides, you can fill color to your text box, add a checklist, bullet list, or number list. When you lasso a certain area, you can choose to take a screenshot, cut, copy, delete, reposition, resize, or recolor it. If you select a format of writings, you can convert them to text. Noteshelf provides handwriting recognition in 65 different languages. This is so commendable. Unlike other mainstream note-taking apps, Noteshelf actually supports the minority languages to take care of every user. I have to give them a credit. Then you can choose to bypass your writing using browse function. Now you can scroll and view your notes using the fingers and styluses. Then you get shape tool here, which reshapes your drawing into better ones. Use magnify function to zoom in and write more precisely. Navigate to any page in the page switcher. Now I'll show you a very cool trick in Noteshelf. Swipe left and let your finger stay. As you can see, now we have some more helpful options. Add a new page or a new template, insert photos from a library, scan document directly into your app, or import files. Noteshelf only allows you to import JPG, PNG, and Noteshelf files, which is kind of limited. Generic files such as docs and PPT are sadly not supported. Another very cool feature is that you can add clip arts in your notes, so as to illustrate your notes by inserting these little pieces of arts. Moreover, you can record while taking notes, just create an audio recorder and done. However, unlike Notability, you cannot click on a stroke to navigate to the timestamp when the certain notes was written. Hope them could make some updates on that later. In addition, you can go into more section to add emojis and vice versa. Then finally, you can export your current page, selected page, or all pages as PNG, PDF, or Noteshelf files. Now let's go through the settings. You can decide how your app looks, switching between these color schemes, selecting your writing style and languages. Adjust the defaults for a stylus, such as you can turn on pressure sensitivity here. Back up your notes through iCloud, Dropbox, OneDrive, Google Drive, or Evernote. Besides, you can publish your work directly to Evernote if you have linked your account together. Next, Apple Schoolwork. This requires that teachers and students all use Noteshelf. If you're not lucky enough to have a teacher who happens to use Noteshelf just like me, well, this is not for you. But if your teachers use Noteshelf, it'll be so great to interact with your teacher this way. Another thing I have to mention is you can directly open a specific note using Siri if you add that note to Siri. You can also secure your note using password, finger ID, or face ID. So that's all of today's video. Comment down below of what you love or are satisfied with this app. If you find my content helpful, please leave a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. See you guys in my next video. Bye!